Fired FBI Director James Comey is going to be testifying in this room on Capitol Hill before the Senate Intel Committee in less than 3 hours. Comey's going to say in his opening remarks that he told President Trump he's not under investigation, but he's also going to reveal that the president demanded loyalty from him. What do the Republicans want to hear from James Comey? Let's talk with Congressman Jim Jordan of Ohio. He's the chairman emeritus of the Conservative Freedom Caucus. Good to have you with us, Congressman. What do you hope comes out today from Jim Comey?
Well, we'll see, but, you know, the real talk, I think, is what was in Mr. Comey's written statement yesterday, which largely confirms what the president's been saying, that he wasn't under investigation, as you've talked about. Nowhere does Mr. Comey mention that there was any collusion between the Trump campaign and the Russians. Nowhere does he mention that there was any obstruction of justice in his written testimony yesterday. In fact, never forget, it was just a month ago, May 3rd, in front of the Senate Judiciary Committee, where Mr. Comey said he was never felt pressured to stop an investigation. So I think yesterday's written statement saying for a long, long time. I think it's also interesting that in that written statement, Mr. Comey says that the president told him to continue the Russian investigation because the president wanted to be vindicated about some of the things said about him. So
where do you
again,
get that?
I think it was good.
I don't know that it's so clear that Jim Comey felt that the president was urging him to continue the investigation. He says exactly
the
opposite.
It was to clear his own name. The thing said about President Trump, it talks about that in the
written
statement.
Him to get the fact out that he wasn't under investigation. I don't think that Jim Comey will hear today in his own words, and this will be the first time he's asked directly about it. He was asked about the DOJ interference, the Attorney General interference. He was never asked about the president's interference in the election until today. But I don't see anywhere in this prepared statement where he says the president was urging him to continue the investigation. Where is that?
Mr. Comey talks about that when Michael Flynn came up in the conversation to continue the Russian investigation, the president was only talking about the Flynn situation and what took place there, not the broader Russian investigation, because there's all kinds of bad things said about the president in the dossier. The president, I think, wanted that cleared as well.
Right.
But again,
he never says the president urged me to continue the investigation. He doesn't say that. He just doesn't. Okay.
Well, okay, but the president wanted that investigation, that part, to continue to clear his name and to clear things up and to get the truth out.
He wanted the fact to come out that he's not under investigation. You think that's the same thing as asking for the investigation to go on?
The president wanted the truth to come out, and what Mr. Comey testified to in the written statement confirms what the president's been saying. Three times he was told that he wasn't under investigation. No obstruction of justice. Mr. Comey even testified under oath that there's no obstruction of justice. So the other interesting things in here too, Chris.
Yes, sir.
It's kind of interesting that the only conversations that were memorialized were the ones between Mr. Comey and Mr. Trump. I'd like to know, and I hope someone asked this today, how come other important events in the Justice Department under Mr. Comey's tenure weren't memorialized?
Well, they weren't?
Well, we'll find out today. Hopefully someone's going to ask this. How about when they made the decision to give Cheryl Mills immunity? After it was key conversations with important Justice Department officials, were those memorialized when that decision was made? How about the day after that Mr. Clinton meets with Loretta Lynch on the tarmac? Was that those decisions or conversation that took place there, were those memorialized? Lots of important things took place in other investigations. Why was this one treated different? So those are the kind of questions I think are interesting and I hope get asked today.
So you think as part of the purview of the Senate Intel Committee on the issue of the Russia investigation, they should talk about issues that have nothing to do with it?
No, I think context is important, right?
Come on.
I want to know all the details about...
That's a political talking point, and we both know it. This has nothing to do with the Russian investigation.
You don't think the American people would like to know key conversations between Mr. Comey and senior Justice Department officials that took place around the event of Loretta Lynch meeting with Bill Clinton on the tarmac 3 days before their scheduled interview? Secretary Clinton. You don't think that's important stuff?
One,
and why, was
not
that memorialized?
Only, I certainly think it's important. I covered it to death. And what I'm saying is Comey's already talked about it, right? Remember when he came in front of the country and said that meeting precipitated his needing to come out to protect the integrity in the investigation? My question to you is, you know this is supposed to be about the Russia investigation. And it is interesting, Congressman, that you are choosing to prioritize something that doesn't have to do with the Russian investigation and ignoring statements from the former director of the FBI, where he says that the president asked him if he wanted to keep his job, when we all know he's got a 10-year term, and that he then said he needs loyalty from him, And when he was told he'd get honesty, he says, I want honest loyalty. And then he asks him, I hope you can see your way to finish this Flynn thing. None of that concerns you.
No, what concerns me is the truth needs to get out. That's what President Trump was trying to have accomplished. And in fact,
how do you
yesterday
know that?
Confirmed that. Yesterday confirmed that. He
how
said
so?
Three times, I wasn't under investigation. Did Mr. Comey's testimony confirm that? It confirmed that
what
yesterday.
What does that have to do with him asking for loyalty, asking to end the Flynn probe, and ask him if he wants his job?
Because he wants the American people to get the truth. That's why he was asking for those
How
things.
Do those
That's
statements speak to get the truth? Drop the Flynn probe. That says get the truth to you? How so?
Well, it's funny, Chris, because even in that discussion in Mr. Comey's testimony yesterday, Mr. Comey even says Mike Flynn's a good guy. That was the context of that conversation. He'd already fired Mr. Flynn. You don't think he understood that Mr. Flynn had did something wrong? He fired the guy.
I think
and even Comey testifies that Mike Flynn is a when President Trump said Mike Flynn's a good guy, what did Mr. Comey say? Yes, he's a good guy.
It's a very interesting read, because all I know is the reason
it's not an interesting read. It's an accurate read. It's what's in the testimony.
It is your reading of what's in the testimony, because if you want to talk about context,
it's the reading.
No,
that's what's in the testimony.
Except that the context of it is that it is a communication, a dialogue.
Now you're talking about context, right?
Well, context certainly matters. I'm saying you don't want to talk about the Russia investigation. You want to bring up what happened in the campaign.
No, I don't.
I'm saying the context
that
of this conversation is a function of a document that James Comey prepared because he was so worried about the conversation. You're making like it was a good conversation.
Comey
memorialized it because he was so troubled by it. He asked not to be left alone with the president because of it.
If he was so worried, why did he say on May 3rd, no one asked him to stop the investigation?
He was asked about the DOJ, not the president. And I do think he has to answer for that. You're right.
Come on, Chris.
He has to answer for that. He has to answer for that.
Of course he does.
Absolutely. Because if he was so concerned that he had to put it all in a document, he had to memorialize it because he was so worried that he asked the AG not to be left alone with the president. Then why didn't he do more? Fair question.
And you don't think the attorney general meeting with the former president 3 days before the secretary of state is to be interviewed by the FBI, you don't think that's important enough that that should be memorialized? You don't think that provides some context?
I think people knew about it.
Maybe Mr. Comey was treating this president different than he did anything else.
I think people knew about it.
Maybe that's part of the problem. Maybe that's why people lost confidence in James Comey. And maybe that's why the president decided that he was going to get rid of James Comey. That's context, and that is all important. The American people believe that's important.
It is important. I think the fact that Comey was fired after saying he wouldn't be loyal and that he wouldn't drop the Flynn probe, very, very relevant. I agree with you about that. What's your take on that? Will you be loyal? Will you drop the Flynn probe? No, you're fired. How do you feel about that chain of events?
Chris, this town had lost confidence in James Comey. Look, I said what Mr. Comey did last July was wrong. I was also one of the few Republicans.
But the president didn't get rid of him at the beginning of his term as he could have.
I was also one of the few Republicans that said what he did in October was wrong as well, right before the election. I thought he screwed that investigation up from the
gate.
I took a lot of heat for that.
I remember that.
So the one who's being consistent is me. All I'm saying is if we're going to be consistent, context is critical throughout Mr. Comey's tenure. That's why he was let go by the president.
I hope he gets asked about all of it today, and we can discuss his answers after. Congressman Jordan, appreciate your take, as always.
You bet.
Be well.
Thanks, Chris.
Allison.
Okay, Chris, we'll get the other side next.